Welcome back. Good morning, dear students. Well set for GSC studies. As you know, yesterday we were doing known living or abiotic component, and two parts of it, that is air and water, are already discussed by us in detail. Today I'm taking the next one, that is light. Come to the next page here. Light. Are you sitting in your study room? Light is coming from outside. What is the source of that? Sun is the source. It means, can you say that sun is the main and ultimate source of light? Ultimate means having no answer of it, no alternate of it. Sun is the ultimate source of light for all the living organisms present on the earth. Here, this sunlight is having the ability to enter into, to penetrate into the forest as well as in the water bodies like oceans, ponds, etc. And the plants present on the surface of the earth and inside the water, whether these are the seas or the ponds, you can say aquatic plants. All these plants use this sunlight for the process of photosynthesis. Now, plants and animals present on the earth behaves or respond or react light in a very different way. I'm just putting forward an example before you. Have you seen the cockroaches, bats, owls, etc.? They are active during the day or night? Your answer will be night. It means that these type of animals hate light. They love darkness only, and that's why they are remain active during the night. But other animals are active during the day. Here, two beautiful examples of plants are also given in our book. First one is morning glory and next one is sunflower. Flowers of these plants bloom with sunrise and closes down after sunset. You can see the beautiful picture of morning glory there. Now come to the next component of environment, dear student, that is next component of abiotic environment, that is soil. Soil provides two things to the living organism. One is the water and mineral for the plants to perform photosynthesis, and next, it acts as the home for many organisms like bacteria, earthworms, termites, rats, etc. In this way, soil is also an important part of abiotic environment. Come to the last one, that is temperature. What is temperature? You can say degree of hotness or coldness of a person, place or thing is called temperature. And this temperature is measured by a device known as thermometer. Here, temperature affects the structure and activities and distribution of plants and animals on the earth. What is the meaning of that? This temperature is responsible for distribution of plants and animals on the earth. I'm just putting forward an example before you. Have you seen polar bears and penguins? Where these animals are found mostly? In the cold climate, while the lion, tiger, elephants are found in the hot areas. Dear student, the structure of these animals is also modified according to the need of the area or need of the temperature there. We will discuss tomorrow. I'm just leaving you with two questions today here. You will think about that. Why buffaloes cool themselves in water during summer, and camel is able to tolerate the heat of desert? Think about it. We will meet tomorrow. Bye-bye, dear students.